Well, hopefully that vine's not supplying water to a bird's nest or something up there.
I don't... Oh! Hey, maybe Tarzan was using it, though. Look at that.
Yeah, that's true. Why don't you swing down there for us, Dad?
Well, we got to take this old dead tree out of here, so I'm sorry, but that vine was going to have to go anyway.
Yeah.
Let me cut it up here, too. Ah. There we go.
Now I'm covered in dirt.
Oh, yeah, we've got some of our viewers watching, I'll bet.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we're Hickok 45. Who are you?
I'm the Anson.
Anson, the Anson of Hickok 45 and Son.
Yep.
Yeah, we're going to talk about a knife today, which is a little different, but we've done a few knives.
Yeah, hang on one second. I'm going to adjust this. Keep talking. We don't have to stop the video. I'm just going to make an adjustment here.
Okay, John's a professional.
Some idiot just, man, he set this camera up so bad.
Who's responsible for that?
Yeah, I think
we're going to talk about a knife. As you could tell from the title, it's probably the SVORD. Forest Ranger Bowie Knife.
Right, it has a V in it, which...
Yeah, I think it's pronounced sword.
Right, but it would be more fun to pronounce it as VORD.
It would.
But
it's
not correct, apparently.
I don't know. Yeah, it's kind of like the word sword, S-W-O-R-D. You want to call it SVORD.
Right, it's kind of like... other languages, they're different for some reason.
For some reason, and then you have that issue of people, if you're Scandinavian or something, you pronounce things differently.
Right.
Then we might pronounce it here, and so you get all those arguments going on.
Right, but even in England, they say things different.
That's right. But anyway, we have a couple of big Bowie knives how'd you get yours?
Well, some really old guy that calls himself my dad got it for me for Christmas. Because he knows I love Bowie knives, especially heavy ones. It seems like Bowie knives are not hard to find, but it's really hard to find the ones that actually have some real weight to them.
Oh,
some
man.
Thickness to the blade.
Yeah, I don't know if y'all can see, but look how thick that sucker is. I mean, they are heavy, big old Bowie knives. And one of you made a comment on the Randall Bowie video about SVORD. You ought to get a SVORD or something about it. And I just went and looked it up to see what it was. And the more I read, the more interested I became. And I researched it, thought, wow, that is cool. You know, because as John was saying, it's hard to find a knife this big and this heavy, this well-made, that's not $1,000.
Right.
Yeah. And these aren't cheap, but they're not $1,000.
Right. And a lot of times you pay that much for a Bowie knife. It's kind of a work of art. Not that these aren't in their own way, but you don't want to use them, you know.
That's right. We look like an ad for these, don't we?
We do, yeah. Well,
we would let you know if we were an ad. It's just it's like a firearm that we happen to buy or get. We like John and I both like big knives, and we got a couple, so we thought we'd do a video on them.
Right.
We were sending us a build a SVORD.
Yeah, it's purely coincidental that I have a SVORD kitchen set now.
Oh, yeah, really. Wow. And they bought you a car, right?
Yeah.
A SVORD truck.
Made out of Bowie knives.
No, I just the more I read, the more I liked it. And I thought, I'll get John one of those. He loves big knives. And the more I read and researched, I thought, you know what? I'm going to order two of those. But they're made by B.W. Baker, New Zealand. I didn't go down and pick them up. Had them delivered. And they're interesting knives because you can read. They even sent along a little pamphlet with the history in the crazy things. A guy named Von Tempsky. He was an adventurer to the extreme. He reminds me of Custer the more I read about him, because he really had a big ego, a lot of flamboyant characteristics about him and everything. And as I did some research, it looks like he might have even met his demise for that reason, charging in when he maybe shouldn't have and that kind of thing. But he led some forest rangers, which are not game wardens. They were, an irregular military force.
Tickets, right?
Yeah, they weren't writing tickets. They're an irregular military force in New Zealand during the New Zealand land wars against the Maori. I believe they're pronounced Maoris. You know, it seemed like a lot of parallels to what went on here with the American, the Native Americans, you know, and that sort of thing. But they went into the bush and did a lot of fighting in the bush in New Zealand. And there was a need for a knife like this, and he actually ordered someone there in Auckland, I think, New Zealand, to make him 30 of these for his men.
And he did. He got the fever for the Bowie knife out in California during the gold rush,
right? Yeah, he learned the value. You know, but again, before firearms had like multiple firing capability, a big old knife was extremely valuable.
Right, and not necessarily to throw. They might have been some people that could do that, but yeah, cutting down trees. Even, 2016, I actually found this thing
Tell that story.
Advantageous just a couple of days ago. It was New Year's Day. Went out with a friend of mine to go shoot a bunch of guns out in the woods. Didn't bring any cameras or anything, just had some fun shooting. And went back in this trail. It was really muddy and kind of mucky back there. It was real rainy all day. And long story short, I got the truck stuck by trying to back it up the trail. And my rear right wheel was just completely suspended over this like 4-foot bank. And we tried everything, couldn't get it out. So we called some local rednecks and they brought a big tractor down and had to literally cut down a tree, probably about, not that big, but about like that. Couldn't quite get your hands around it. And this thing made short work of it and got the tractor through and pulled the truck out. So
yeah, the utilitarian
1800s value. Technology,
That's right, it comes down to it. And that's what we were saying earlier. It's easy to find big old knives like this, but so often they're very expensive. Beautiful bone handle or something, stag, and they're polished like that Randall. And you hate to take it out in the woods and use it at a campsite.
Right.
So that's why we sound like salespeople. No, it wouldn't matter who made them. And I'm just delighted because I had a hard time. As much as I like big knives. And at gun shows, knife shows, I'm always drawn to the bigger knives, but they're always like collector's items, or they're beautiful, or they're really expensive, or they're all three.
Right.
And so for hacking around, it's hard to find one.
And I think part of why they're hard to find is because, like, we don't hunt, so we don't have as much of an interest in kind of the smaller, medium-sized knives.
Hunting knives.
Like skinning or hunting, actually.
Of all things.
Killing a deer with one.
That's right.
That's what they're
for,
right?
No, this is a hunting knife.
Yeah, really. But kind of, because I grew up out here and Dad, you've been out here for a while,
right? Yeah, a little bit before you.
So I'm used to, hacking on stuff and chopping down, small trees and big limbs and stuff like that. And you need a big, heavy, thick knife to do that kind of thing.
Yeah.
And I think a lot of people don't necessarily live in an area where you can just hack. You can't just like go on a hiking trail in Gatlinburg and just start hacking the woods up.
Yeah.
You got to have your own place,
That's true. We forget that we're quite different. You ever notice?
I think so.
So yeah, if you live in the city and you go hunting, you probably have a nice 5 or 6 inch hunting knife for skinning or for maybe something from around the campfire, but you don't have as much use for a big old knife because as I've talked about before in our big knife videos knife videos where they're big knives, we use them for just cutting the trails, keeping the limbs from growing into the trails where we hike or bike and that kind of thing. So it's in and around the campsite, so there's a use for them. Right. It's kind of like a hatchet.
Right, and the weight makes a huge difference.
Yeah.
It really does.
Sweet. But yeah, anyway, with old Von Tempsky, his actual full name was Gustavus Ferdinand. I pronounce all that.
Gustav.
But he had 30 of these made, and then SVORD, the baker, decided to make a replica of those knives that Von Tempsky kind of made famous. In his adventures and the wars and the battles, in New Zealand.
Well, how come he didn't get me one of the original ones? Were you like cheap or something?
Well, I think there's only one of them in existence they know of.
Sounds like an excuse to me.
Yeah, these things, I think they make them out of Swedish steel. So it's not like some of these, I'm about to insult an entire country of people, but the Pakistani knives or something that you'll see for $20. John just had to have a knife about this big. What, how old were you? 5?
Probably.
Yeah. If you remember those, they're probably collector's items now, but they're about this big, a big old Bowie knife made in Pakistan. And they were literally like what, 10 bucks or something?
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's not an insult to a whole country. They know what they're making. There's probably made in Pakistan that are really good.
That's true. And every country makes cheap knives.
Right. There's American made knives that are garbage.
Exactly. So. They were so cheap. It was so funny.
Yeah.
I had a hard time when he was young. Maybe I did give him the fever, but when he was little, we'd be at a knife show, gun show or something. He'd always want a knife. Dad, we'd take that knife. It'd be some, fairly large knife or some folding knife, and it's $2, or $3. Yeah. I try to talk him out of it.
Yeah, you were the one that gave me my allowance, so it's his fault for not buying better knives.
That's pretty bad. Normally, you don't want to talk your youngsters out of being frugal and, spending their money wisely, but It's like buying a $30 gun. You know, you don't want to buy a $2 knife. So.
Right, it can be dangerous, especially a small thin blade can break on you.
Yeah, for that reason, it can be dangerous.
So. I had one of those, I think it was Ontario knives or something
snapped,
like that.
Snapped, didn't it?
Yeah, I was just hacking on something like this, you know, that was laying over, and literally the about 2 inches of the end of the blade just broke clean off and went flinging off down into the woods.
Yeah,
and those
aren't what you'd consider really cheap knives either.
No.
You gotta be careful about the steel you get and all that, but
yeah.
So I don't know. These are pretty cool.
Well, it's neat that they're good knives, very usable, practical, but then they also have a cool story behind them too.
Yeah,
it's a replica of something really interesting.
Yeah. I didn't know there were any more stories to the Bowie knife. Bowie knife has an interesting story behind it,
right?
As it is. So.
Which Bowie knife is I've learned later in life. That's a pronect. That's the correct pronunciation.
That's right.
But I always called him Bowie.
Yeah, it's Bowie. Bowie is technically what it is. And
I think of something that floats on water.
But. That's right. And I think we talked about that in some of those videos, how even the exact design of the Bowie knife is not known to be, you know, what size his knife was, how much it weighed and all that. A lot of these are bigger than the knives that he carried, and that a lot of the knives that are considered Bowie knives are not this big.
It's kind of like Michael Jordan's shorts. He was famous for having baggy shorts.
Yeah.
But if you look back in those days, like, those shorts are not baggy
at
all.
That's right.
So. But he was the first. So the first Bowie knives were Jordan baggy shorts.
That's right. So anyway, we like big knives, and we have an actual use for them. Of course, you don't have to have a use to.
No, you don't. Put it on your wall.
I mean, they just work. Where was that? Oh, yeah, that vine, you know.
That's true.
They're good for chopping, good for cutting. Now it's heavy, I'll have to say. I don't know what it weighs, but that's heavier than carrying a High Point, wouldn't you say, on your belt?
Yeah, and I hate to say it, but a High Point would probably defend you a little better than this.
Yeah, it might do it. I was reading too about Von Tempsky. They trained, he was supposedly an expert knife fighter, and they used the knife, how they say it, the spine of it parallel to his forearm, something like that.
Yeah.
And they would have a revolver in the other hand, and they would fend off the attacker with the knife and then use the revolver and all. I don't know, maybe I'll be legend, who knows. I just don't really relish the idea of fighting with a knife, put it that way.
Yeah, my plan for a knife fight is, if someone pulls a knife on me, I'm gonna pull my knife. And if they come towards me, I'm going to run.
Yeah, really.
That's my plan. Or pull a gun out.
I'm going to pull my Glock.
If I didn't have a gun.
Anyway, that's a sword. It's called the Forest Ranger Bowie. And we enjoy them, as you can probably tell. Glad to have them. And I thought we'd share them with you. Okay. Believe it or not, we're not selling sword knives. Isn't it funny? It's had the feeling we're doing an infomercial for some reason.
Yeah, well.
Maybe because we doubled up on them, you know.
Right. Well, you know, people throw that shill word around. I mean, if you like something, you like something. You guys know that from watching our videos. There's some things that we just like.
That's right.
You know, it doesn't mean that we're taking money from anybody.
And don't do that at home. That's dangerous. Yeah, we just like to share.
Now I got it. Now.
No, you don't have as many years practice. Oh, good.
I can do it. Yeah. I've been around the block a few times.
We're setting a poor example for our viewers. So anyway, we have a disclaimer in every description. Don't do this at home.
Yeah.
Anyway, glad you came out to see us be silly and chop around a little bit with our new Bowie knives.
I always remember knife safety, treat all knives as if they are sharp.
Yes, treat them all as they're loaded and sharp. So,
yep.
Life is good. Since I'm still here, let me go ahead and thank SDI, the Sonoran Desert Institute, for their support of the channel. If you're not familiar with them, they do distance learning. They're fully accredited. You can get a certification in gunsmithing there. You can even get an associate degree in firearms technology, and you can go on to do a lot of different things with that, you know, if you're interested. So, there's hands-on training and everything. So check the link in the description, sdi.edu, and, check it out. I do a lot of work with veterans, so it might be of some interest to you. So check that out. And also, keep in mind while I've got you, while I'm still here, that we are on Full 30 now. All our videos are over on full30.com, and there's a link in the video descriptions to that as well. So, watch us wherever you like to, YouTube, Full 30, better yet, both. and keep in mind that we have the Hickok 45 and Son channel. John does a lot of things over there. I do some things over there, some Hickok history, different things. We've got the Hickok 45 Facebook page. We do a lot on that. There's 400,000 people following that. I hope you're one of them. The Hickok 45 and Son Facebook page. So got a lot going on there. Got the Gun Culture Radio show that John does. Now I'm on that show sometimes over on Hickok 45 and Son. So just wanted to make you aware of everything that's going on in case you might not be familiar with it. Okay. And you'd better start getting familiar with it, because if you don't, I'm going to come to your house and have a chat with you. You don't want that to happen. And if I do, you'd better have good donuts and good coffee waiting for me. Okay?